Hello everyone, this is ASM Arif today welcoming you to my new Photoshop tutorial. Today I'll show you how to edit outdoor portrait a new way. So let's start. At first I'm going to the file and just opening up a stock image which is downloaded from the devinet.com. Oh, one thing is that if you are new in my channel, so you have to subscribe my channel and just press the bell icon and you'll get new tutorials a lot. Okay, this one I'll edit. At first make copy, dragging and dropping in this layer. This one is the copy layer or take new layer. Okay, after that you can apply dodge burn in this photo. So just copy another two layers and press just A and S. Okay, turning up A and selecting the S layer and making it green mode. Going to the blending options and here is a slider. You can adjust the light with that. When you're finding the light in a face and press the alter button, it will divide and adjust the light. You can hit the OK and after that mask this one and go to the image, apply image and hit OK and select the A image and make it multiply. After multiply this one, go to the blending options again and here is another slider. You have to adjust the shadow with that. Press the alter button and divide this one and adjust the shadow with that and hit the OK. Mask this one and go to the image and apply image and in this case make it invert and hit OK. Okay, after that select these two layer, make it group and make it masks also and go to the image and apply image and uncheck the invert option and hit OK. You'll get subtle change over there. Okay, that's good. And after that go to the file and place embedded. Here is light collection and I'll take a light effect which is this one and just press the shift button and rotate this one and leave this like that. Okay, and hit the OK and go to the filter. Before that make it crystallize and go to the filter and the blur options and Gaussian blur and apply the Gaussian blur a little bit. Okay, that's good and hit OK. After that go to the adjustment layer and from the curves use the blue curves and just dot give this there and make it like that and from the red curves use the curves and make it like this, little bit change and the RGB curves select here and add some drama like that and make it down. Okay, that's good and select all the things in a group and after that make it merge by pressing Ctrl Shift Alter key and go to the filter and camera filter. From the camera filter I'll adjust the light, color, face, other things. At first I'll go to the camera calibration and make like that. Okay, and the green saturation increase and I'll make green like that. Adjust the hue of the primary red color and from the HSL I'll decrease the saturation of orange, increase the saturation a little bit and decrease the just red color luminance a little bit and from the basic panel I'll reduce the highlight, add some shadow a little bit, decrease the blacks and from the sharpness I'll add some sharpening amount and luminance of noise reducer like that and from HSL I'll give some aqua like that and decrease the green color saturation. Okay, and luminance a little bit, that's good. And after that increase the orange color, decrease the saturation of orange a little bit like that and hit the OK button and you'll get change from the before and after. Okay, and go to the adjustment layer, color lookup and from the Fujifilm effect like that or you can use the Kodak effect but I think Fujifilm this one is good and just make the opacity down select these two things and make it group, make it merge. And after that, go to the filter again and the Google Nick collection filter and Color Effects Pro 4. From the Color Effects Pro, I will apply another just effect from there. So it's loading. Here is the cross processing, and I'll add filter from here. This one, or you can choose any of them. Okay, I'm using T01 and the strength is 34 or 35%, shadow 0 and highlight 0. You can adjust the opacity like that. Okay, and hit the OK button. It will take time to save it own self, and okay, you'll get like a change. Okay, after that, go to the gradient options and select the last gradient and make it radial, make it reverse, make it 300%, and dither, take the dither and 0, and just take here and hit OK. After that, go to the adjustment layer again and the hue saturation options. From the hue saturation options, you can make the hue or saturation like that. Increase the 1 is good, and you can add some saturation like that. Well, this one is actually a warmy effect, so don't worry about that, about the skin tone. And from the color balance, and you can adjust the color like that. Okay, -4 and green color, -2 and blue color, you can make it like that. That's good. And from the color or photo filter, from the photo filter, I will add a cool photo filter like that for the neutralize the all warm color, and just decrease the fill like that. That's good. And from the adjustment layer, from the color lookup, and I will add like that the whole blue color and decrease the fill and decrease the opacity. Okay, that's good. And select all the things, make it group and merge this one. And let's see, this one is our previous photo, and after reading that, we are getting this nice effect and warm tone, and before and after. Okay, I should add more sharpness over there. That's why I'm making copy of this layer and making it vivid light, the blending mode. And from the filter options, here is other and high pass. Okay, I'll make 0.5. That's good, and hit OK. We'll get extra just sharpness from this effect. Okay, before one and after one. Okay, and from there, from the adjustment layer, I'll go to the level and increase the level, adjust the level like that. Okay, that's good. It will more shiny. Make it group, make it merge. Let's see what was the previous and after. This one is the previous and after. You are getting nice vintage effect and the warm vintage effect, whatever you can tell. So thank you so much. This one is our output. Thanks for watching my video tutorial. If you have any kind of question or query, please do comment on my video comment section. And if you have any kind of request, please leave your request in my video comment section or my community section. So don't forget to subscribe my channel. If you have any kind of query, so feel free to contact with me. Till the next video, I am ASM Arif, signing out, and bye bye. Thank you.